What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Today I am taking advantage of this beautiful weather and I am installing a microwave, the inverter, the microwave, trying to squeeze the subwoofer and my amplifier into this tiny bunk. So there's the old rig there parked up. If you want to see how much room, I mean, you can obviously tell it was a bigger bunk. I had tons of space to do whatever I wanted. Let me just walk over here quickly. So yeah, like, look at this huge bunk. I mean, I had my microwave on a shelf. I had my subwoofer under the bed comfortably. And I still had tons of room for everything else. So on this smaller bunk, it's a real tight challenge to get everything to fit, but I don't want to compromise, guys. Like, really, I'm on the road. I'm always doing long hauls. And at the end of the day too, like, you know, spending money on fast food and stuff. And plus you get a gut, like, I'm already packing on some pounds here. So I'll show you what I've got done so far. And yeah, so enjoy. I can't see. I'm gonna utilize you guys. Oh, there we go. Pretty simple. I'm gonna have to strap this down. So I had a ratchet strap on it in the other truck because it had hooks on that side and that side, but this one obviously does not. So I'm gonna have to find a way to secure it down. Maybe I'll drill a hole and put some I guess, what do they call, eye bolts on each side, and then ratchet strap it. So all right, guys, so I'll quickly explain what I've done here already. So this truck came pre-wired. Well, it was wired for an inverter before. Someone took it out, so they left this ground wire here. It goes to there. I might change that, but they had a really skinny gauge power wire and I'm not feeling that, so I replaced it with a 2-gauge that I took from my truck. So they already had a hole in the floor, ran down right here through the battery box, fused right here. So yeah, it's fused and then to the terminal. So that's good to go. Mounted it to the top, that way I can just run my microwave here. I have my subwoofer there, 212s. I don't know how it's gonna sound in this tiny little enclosure. Let me show you guys here. Don't mind the mess, I'm just like really tossing everything around. So the other option was to throw it under here, and guys, I haven't got this thing detailed yet. It's still like in the condition that I got it in, so I'm gonna have to like shampoo the carpets, as you can see. Like, look at the carpets. So I to fit it inside this space here, from the carpet to the bottom of the bottom of the bed there, that's like 11.5, 12 inches there, and my subwoofer on the narrowest side is 13.5, so that wasn't gonna work. So what I did was, there was a bracket that went through that hole there that came across. You see that one bolt that has no nut on it? So there was a bracket there. I had to remove that bracket to slide the subwoofer in. And yeah, so this is how you fit 212s and a 36 inch bunk, aka coffin bunk. So so yeah, microwave is gonna go here. I'm gonna put my amp, I'm gonna mount it to the side of the subwoofer there, but I'm gonna change the amp. The amp that I'm running, I don't know where it is. I think it's under here. Oh yeah, it's right there. I think it's a Rockford Fosgate. It's a good, it's an old school good amp. It hits hard, but then when I'm driving for, I don't know, 4 hours at least, then what ends up happening is it gets way too hot and then it shuts down. So I played with all the gain settings. I have the gain turned down. I've tried to fine tune it the best that I could, but yeah, so I'm gonna have to get a bigger amp, maybe something that comes with a fan on it, because you know, when we're long hauling and I'm bumping tunes for 4 hours straight, the amps is bound to get hot, right? Like, you see these inverters, they come with fans. So if I can get an amp that either is rated for more, so that's not working so hard, or get something with a fan. So right now, that's what I'm working on. Pretty soon, I ordered some paint and primer and whatever for this. I think, guys, I think I'm gonna keep it black for the time being, because I like the murdered stealth look. Like, certain things I'll polish, like the stocks. You know, make sure that everything that's shiny stays shiny, but anything that's black, I like the murdered look. The wheels are gonna have to polish, look at them. So the wheels are getting polished, and then I'm gonna get some spike lugs here, and then just have it like a real, like, gangster truck, you know what I mean? That in the nighttime, all you see is lights and you don't even know, like, what kind of truck it is, right? So guys, this is what I'm working on. It's a beautiful, beautiful day. There's the old truck there. And yeah, thanks for watching. Get out there, enjoy the weather, grab a drink, water, beer, whatever, and keep wrenching. Lunchtime.